Meet the Stratolaunch, the world's biggest aircraft by wingspan. You won't see it at your local airport, as it was designed to carry rockets, not people. There's only one of it made, and it first flew on 13 April this year. Unfortunately, it hasn't flown again since, and probably never will. Usually, rockets are sent into space by launching them vertically from the Earth's surface. Now, a new method is being developed whereby they are launched in mid-air from a conventional horizontal takeoff aircraft. The latter presents numerous significant advantages over the former, particularly because of the reduced mass, thrust, and ultimately cost of the rocket. When a rocket is being launched by a high-flying airplane, it doesn't need to fly through the low, much denser atmosphere, the drag of which requires a considerable amount of extra work and thus mass of the propellant or fuel for the rocket. On 13 December 2011, billionaire Microsoft co-founder Paul Allen and aviation maverick Burt Rutan, the man behind Spaceship One, unveiled their new company, Stratolaunch Systems, which aimed to create airport-like operations for space travel. 6 years and a few hundred million dollars later, the Stratolaunch was rolled out for the first time. Nicknamed Rogue after a mythical bird in the fairy tale Sinbad, so big it could carry an elephant, the sheer size of this plane is jaw-dropping. Its wingspan is 117 meters long, the longest ever built, surpassing the huge H4 Hercules flying boat by almost 20 meters. Two U-747s were cannibalized for engines, avionics, flight deck, landing gear, and other proven systems to be installed on the Stratolaunch to reduce initial development costs. One fuselage is not enough for this monster, so they put two on it, each with its own empennage. Although the two fuselages look identical, only the right fuselage cockpit is usable to accommodate the flight crew. The left fuselage cockpit is left empty and unpressurized. On 15 October 2018, Paul Allen died from complications of non-Hodgkin's lymphoma, which is a type of cancer. Following his death, Paul's sister Jody Allen, who is the chair of Stratolaunch System parent venture Vulcan Inc., decided to end the development of the aircraft. She also decided to let the aircraft fly to honor her brother's wishes and also to prove the aircraft's capability. On 13 April, Stratolaunch took off from the Mojave Air and Spaceport for the first time. It flew for about 2.5 hours, reaching the altitude of 15,000 feet and 165 knots in speed. On 31st of May 2019, it was announced that the company would cease its operations. The following month, the Stratolaunch, along with all the company facilities, equipment, and intellectual property, was put up for sale for $400 million. Fret not, this is not the end of the air launch to space concept. Another company, Virgin Orbit, owned by billionaire Richard Branson, also plans to air launch satellites, but with a Boeing 747. In fact, Virgin Orbit's sister outfit, Virgin Galactic, has managed to send its Spaceship 2 to the suborbital by launching it from a carrier aircraft, bringing us one step further in the reinvention of space exploration.